traffic on that. Yeah, but we can just that we have to go up inside.
The Tox Utat has fallen into the hands of the Tholians. Our intelligence indicates increased Tholian activity in the Nakul system. Caldano believes they are trying to interfere with the Nakul in the present because of actions they will take in the future. Caldano has asked you to rendezvous with him in the Nakul system.
Accept. Let's go. Already close to the end, and there was a diamond apartment. This is a natural road. This. You stay on that base. No money. This is a natural road. Yes, this is a
doing screen.
Don't go on red.
Good to see you again. Thank you for responding to my message so quickly. The Tholians have the quantum phase inhibitor. I've tracked their ship to this system, and I'm detecting some telltale quantum fluctuations within the star. They're trying to use the device. We need to stop them and recover it. First, however, we need to help the Nakul. At this point in their history, they're not prepared to repel a Tholian attack.
Agreed. That's a cause and lead to that town, that's on Tholian Pesa. Let's do this. Yes, it Agreed. Set a course for the GG Salonian vessel. The Naku are here now, sir. They'll put them on the main ship.
Unidentified vessel. You have entered our space without authorization. If you are an ally of the Tholians, leave now. We have done nothing to provoke their attacks, but we will defend ourselves.
And your sisters return. What do you need?
Thank you. My people have few warships. Any assistance you can provide against the Tholians would be appreciated.
Concert. It done. Yes, please, Tyler. I am back.
I was only focused on the idea, on whether it was possible. I didn't stop to think of all the harm it could do in the wrong hands. We have to stop the Tholians before they shut down the star's fusion. If that happens, the effect on the system will be devastating. The Nakul will lose their home, and life will probably never develop here again.
The Lethalian ship has the quantum phase inhibitor. They're going to use it on the star. We have to stop them. The
might have traced it to this time. We'll have to report that we captured by that quantum phase inhibitor.
Ah. cowboy and lock on it. So much and then we can have it here towards the Saturn. Ja, die kann man nicht mehr. Da ist er. Das ist mein First Officer. Ist gut. Ich bin noch ein paar Patienten, die Status. Ist gut.
We've docked with a Tholian ship. The good news is that my scans indicate the quantum phase inhibitor is on the bridge. All we need to do is go get it. The bad news is that the Tholians know we're here. They're not gonna give up without a fight.
plant. There's a door. Plant.
Tholians, just as xenophobic and opportunistic in your time as mine. We have to be getting closer to the Tox Utat. Stay alert. The bridge should be just ahead. Finally, we have the quantum phase inhibitor. I brought this device through time to hide it from the Vorgons, but I never thought the Tholians would steal it. Now we need to hide it where we're safe from both of them. Are you ready? This will be a longer trip than you're used to taking.
Set a course for the Risa system.
Risa, early 22nd century. Even the tourists won't be in this region for a few years yet. No one will be looking for the quantum phase inhibitor here. Not now, anyway. Let's try that cave up ahead. Looks like a good spot.
Wow, rain on Risa. I guess they haven't installed the weather control systems yet. We have to hide the device very well. I can't afford to let it fall into the wrong hands again. And the Vorgons are very persistent. No, that's too obvious. Anyone can find it there. That's better, but I still think it will be too easy to find.
That's it. Someone will find it in a few hundred years, but that's a different story for a different captain. Let's get back to your time. We need to check on the Nakul. Setting course for 24
We need to get back to the Nakul.
Oh, Captain Walker of the USS Pasta.
We are responding to a temporal distress call. Do you require assistance?
Resolve this. Prepare for transport.
Beam to the fast stack. Some funny ship here. The fast stack.
Greetings. It's nice to see you again.
Again, we have having before. We have found men.
Not that you remember. We need to scan the continuum for Kaldano. Would you care to assist me?
Of course.
Were you able to locate Cal Dano? Enter the temporal coordinates into the transporter. What happened with Cal Dano?
He's dead. I guess that he's been dead for every year.
No, this was meant to happen. Cal Dano went further back into the past than you knew. The NX-01 Enterprise, captained by Jonathan Archer, found his ship in the 22nd century. And his chief engineer activated Caldano's emergency temporal circuit, which returned the ship to its last known time, this one. But by the time that happened, Caldano had been dead for centuries. The Toxbustan is safe. It was found in the mid-24th century by Captain Jean-Luc Picard, who destroyed it before it could be used to harm others. Altering the past causes ripples. The effects move through time, shifting everything they touch, and it may take eons for all of them to be seen. The Na'kul will survive, although their homeworld will be lost. They will become time travelers themselves, and their actions in the Temporal Cold War shape the galaxy you now know. There are some things you shouldn't change, that you can't change. You could check Captain Archer's old logs for more information, but you will know all about it soon enough. You are entering a dangerous era in history. Time travel like warp drive before it will radically change your society. I'll see you again. We have a lot to do.
Very Captain. Are you ready to eat the ship?
This is a sad day for the Federation. We failed to save the Na'kul system. And our friend from the future, Cal Dano, is dead. I know you did everything you could. Sometimes, especially when we venture into time travel, things must play out a certain way. So, at least the timeline has been preserved. Captain Picard can now find the Toxuthot on Risa in the 24th century. Still, let us mourn for Cal Dano and the Na'kul people.
Yeah.
We have been contacted by the Federation from the 29th century. Their Temporal Integrity Commission is charged with protecting the timeline from factions who might want to change history. Considering our recent experiences, we feel the need to better understand the rules of time travel. However, it's important we don't know too much about the future, so we have decided to designate one representative to learn what we need to know. Given your record, you were the logical choice. You were to rendezvous with the USS Postop. Her captain will give you a more thorough briefing upon arrival. We have been contacted by the Federation from the 29th century. Their Temporal Integrity Commission is charged with protecting the timeline from factions who might want to change history. Considering our recent experiences, we feel the need to better understand the rules of time travel. However, it's important we don't know too much about the future, so we have decided to designate one representative to learn what we need to know. Given your record, you were the logical choice. You were to rendezvous with the USS Postop. Her captain will give you a more thorough briefing upon arrival.
this. But if you like my content, subscribe and touch the like button. 3, 2, 1, thanks. Press rocket. Continue. Yes, roll.
Please report to the USS Postdoc.
It's a pleasure to see you again. I'm glad you were selected as your time's representative. I can't imagine a better selection. Of course, I already knew you were going to be chosen, but that doesn't change my appreciation. Your recent experiences with time travel have begun a new phase of development, and a perilous one at that. Understanding the rules of time travel is of vital importance. Starfleet personnel are strictly forbidden from directly interfering with historical events and are required to maintain the timeline when possible. We're also restricted from revealing too much about the future. These principles have served Starfleet well. Now that the time travel genie is out of the bottle, it will be hard to get it back in. The tech has spread through the galaxy, and species after species will learn the secrets of time.
Are you ready to visit the future?
Here we are. Since you're from the past, I'll be your chaperone during the event, hopefully protecting you from any temporal incidents. Purely procedural, of course. You've already demonstrated your ability to remain silent about things you aren't supposed to know.
Welcome, gentle being, to the signing of the Temporal Accords. Your biosigns aren't listed on our register today. I'll need to... wait. I know you. I wrote a paper about you in classical history class at the Academy. I must say, you look much younger than your holo images. Wait, what year did you come from? Oh, that explains why you look so young. Well, you sure have an eventful future ahead of you. Forget I said that. I'm not supposed to say things like that. To be honest, I'm still getting used to the new temporal regulations. They can be a little confusing. Anyway, the TIC crews are scrubbing the hall for anything that might cause a paradox if visitors from the past, like yourself, encounter them. It will be just a few moments. Perhaps you would like to chat with some of our other guests here in the lobby. I believe they have all been cleared for trans-temporal interactions. I'm sure you'll have plenty to talk about.
Greetings, friend. How may I help you? Where do I start? I'm 157 years old. That's only because I spent 90 years caught in a temporal distortion. Back then, I was serving as an ensign under Captain Bateson on the USS Postman. After that, integrating back into Starfleet was difficult. So much had changed. Some of my shipmates joined temporal investigations. Their first-hand knowledge of past events was quite useful. Seemed like a way to make a difference. So that's where I ended up as well. Pretty certain we haven't met until just now. Not yet, at least. I just graduated from the Academy as a temporal agent. That being said, it's quite possible that we will meet in the future. Well, my future. Tell you what, I'll try to act surprised when it happens.
The Na'vul are here to protest the signing of these unlawful biased accords. The Tholians ravaged our homeworld thanks to the Federation's ineptitude. In one dark moment, my people were scattered throughout the stars. All we were, our history, our way of life, was nearly lost. And when we needed the Federation the most, we were denied. Terrorists. Criminals, the dregs of the galaxy. These words, these deeds will never be forgotten or forgiven. Today, the Federation and their lackeys come to tell the galaxy which timeline is best and what they'll do to keep it that way. But who are they to dictate such terms? To tell us that their history is more important than ours? My existence? My existence has been nothing but hardship and pain. The life of an exile. I'd gladly sacrifice it to restore my homeworld and prevent the mass exodus of my people. Don't tell me you wouldn't do the same, were our places reversed.
Attention all guests, the main hall is now open. Please make your way to your seats.
Assembly will succeed by any means necessary. That is all.
Jolan Tru, you are from the past, from before the time the Romulans joined the Federation, I'll wager. How strange all of this must be for you. The entire galaxy unites in preserving the timeline. This is truly a momentous day for all.
I am honored by the Founders, and pleased to observe this most historic event. Although the Dominion was not greatly affected by the development of time travel, we have an interest in safeguarding the time stream. I can't help but ponder the opportunities for temporal abuse that will remain after they are signed. I fear great imbalance could occur, despite the very good intentions of all the signatories involved.
Incursion into the timeline has been overlooked, perhaps because of its importance to the founding of the Galactic Union. We proposed an amendment to restore our home world in the timeline, but it was rejected. Therefore, we are here, with all eyes of the galaxy upon us, to point out the hypocrisy and unlawfulness of these accords.
Delegates and honored guests, your attention, please. The signing ceremony is about to begin. Please take your seat.
Representatives from dozens of species have gathered to witness this historic event. It looks like
they are getting ready to begin the formal signing. Of course, this is the larger ceremony. The negotiations. Wait, there is some kind of disturbance.
This oppression will not stand. The time stream shall be free. We will liberate the galaxy from the tyranny of the temporal accords. We shall wipe the stain of the Federation from history.
Quick, get the delegates to safety. The Krennic are taking the delegates hostage. The Krennic have grabbed the delegates and are holding them hostage in some nearby offices. This is damn peculiar. We're facing a major temporal flux here. The hostiles have neutralized embassy security, but it looks like they weren't expecting us to be here. It's up to us to rescue the delegates. Neutralize them as quickly as possible. We need to save those delegates.
I shall live to serve the Founders another day. My thanks to you, of course.
It was a good day to die for the Krenner.
Was at an end. My thanks for proving me wrong.
This wasn't supposed to happen. History says the accords were signed and there was no mention of an attack.
Those look like Krennan ships.
This is a kind of ship. Yeah, that look for how to cut this stuff. But these are the stuff.
This conference will not continue. I won't abide it. All ships fire at will. Leave no survivors. Prevail. Taste the bitter dregs of failure.
Thank you.
the Nakul have used the Krenim attack as a cover to attack the temporal sensor array. All our forces are tied up fighting the Krenim. We can't afford to lose that array. It monitors the time stream for incursions. If it were damaged, people could travel into the past without being detected. Curious. The Krenim and Nakul vessels have started fighting each other in the confusion. Let's make the most of that, shall we? the run over here. Stay focused on the array.
Engaging anoraks now. The more, the merrier.
seem to remember a little about him from my briefing on your timeline. He was a Krenim researcher on the Anorak's timeship project, if memory serves.
I thought as much. Something must have disturbed the timeline. I'm afraid you will need to return to your own time to investigate. I'll accompany you, but I can't interact with anybody from your time. I'll open a portal when you're ready. Are you ready now?
Welcome back to Kiana. We hadn't expected to see you again so soon. To what do we owe the pleasure?
Noi?
Well, he's been working on some secret project of late. To be honest, he's been more than a little hostile. And that's saying something for Noi. I was about to check in with him, if you would like to accompany me.
Report to command if you want to know what I'm working on. Feel free to waste the time of the charming bureaucrat standing next to you, but I'll thank you to stop wasting mine. Now, this interrogation is over. I've more important matters to attend to. Good day.
Behind.
Wow.
I can't believe it. How could he do such a thing? What drove him to betray us like this? There's only one way to find out. Computer, bring up the research notes and personal logs of researcher Noi. Authorization Trala 23, Victor 6, Sigma.
Personal log supplement. We had some visitors from the Alliance today. Noi was rather rude to them, but I managed to smooth things over. This time. Still, he has good reason to be stressed. The war isn't going well, and there's a lot of pressure on him right now. He could be a bit more agreeable, however. Perhaps a peace offering. Those Terran snack cakes he's so fond of with the... What is the word? Nougat. I tried to tell him about the baby again last night, but he was so stressed out, I just couldn't add to his burden. Hopefully things will calm down a bit soon and I can tell him. On a positive note, my work is progressing quite well. I believe these logs should now be shielded from any kind of temporal incursion.
Thank you. selection halo.
Personal log supplemental. My review of the time capsule files is complete. What I have learned has shocked to the very core of my being. I had a wife, and she was pregnant. My wife and unborn child were murdered by the Federation and their allies. They were devastated by people, murdered my family, and erased an entire species from time and space. I cannot let this stand. This I vow. I shall not rest until I have restored my family or avenged their deaths. Time itself shall be the instrument of my vengeance. Personal log supplemental. At last, I have found them. The Teutarians. Or rather, what they have become. Some of them managed to escape the treachery of the Federation, finding sanctuary in a trans-dimensional void. They are powerful. So powerful that some primitive species worship them like gods. And yet, they are trapped in their realm. No longer able to exist within prime space. But I can help them. I can release them from Durin's fire with these buildings at my side. I shall have my vengeance for Flama.
Please input your selection halo.
Do this.
I have been waiting for this for a long time. At last, I take the first fateful steps upon my path of vengeance.
But after seeing you, when you get your eyes, what have you done with your eyes?
As always, is so limited. For you, it has been moments, but for me, it has been years. Years of planning, building, all to return to this moment in time, to end you.
This doesn't have to happen.
Oh, but it does, believe me. You took them. My wife, my unborn child. Time was your weapon then, and it is mine now. With I will eradicate your wretched alliance. Just as you wiped the Teutarians from history. But first things first. It's time for you to die.
I don't think so, you are science. That is not it.
This is Walker. We've got our hands full with Noy over here. But we'll keep him busy while you defend the station. We could use a hand.
So, Noi turned against us, huh? This is troublesome. With his theft of the Anoraks, he poses a great threat to the galaxy. Sadly, I don't think we've seen the last of him. The surprise actions of the Nakul are also a concern. What could they be up to, I wonder? Regardless, I think you'll agree, the battlefield just got a lot bigger. Data from the future you